Welcome to the series on Azure Migrate, your free migration and modernization platform, which helps you move workloads in a consistent and secure manner to Azure. In this video, we will show you how to discover your Hyper-V estate. Before proceeding, ensure that you have watched the video describing how to create an Azure Migrate project. Things to take care of: ensure the appliance meets networking requirements and can connect to necessary endpoints. Prepare the Hyper-V hosts for discovery using the script shared in documentation. For deeper discovery of Hyper-V estate and to enable software inventory, agentless dependency analysis, and performance-based assessments, domain account or Windows and Linux guest credentials are required. For discovering SQL Server instances and databases, create least privileged credentials following this guide. To discover .NET web apps and Apache Tomcat web servers running on Linux servers, set up least privileged guest credentials. From the Azure Migrate Project Overview page, click on Discover Using Appliance and select the virtualization environment as Hyper-V. Provide a name for the appliance and generate the project key. In this demo, we will showcase how to convert any of your existing servers to appliance VM using the downloaded zip file. A new appliance VM can also be set up using a VHD template. Execute the zip file, Azure Migrate installer file, as an administrator, and select the appliance type as Hyper-V. Select the cloud type and whether the appliance will be set up with public endpoint or private endpoint connectivity. After the zip file execution is completed, the Appliance Configuration Manager web app is launched automatically. The first check ensures that you can connect to the necessary Azure endpoints. If the server is running behind a proxy server, add the proxy server details. Authentication and non-authentication types of proxy servers are supported. If using an authentication-based proxy, you can enter those details. The time sync check ensures that the time in the appliance is in sync with Azure to ensure that discovery is done smoothly. The next step is where you register this appliance with the Azure Migrate project. Here we need to paste the project key that we had created in Azure Portal. In this step, upgrade and registration operations are executed together. By default, auto-upgrade is enabled, and you don't need to worry about the management of the appliance. The next step is where you need to log in to Azure. The user account that you use here should have sufficient privileges to register the appliance to the project. After the prerequisite checks are completed, add the credentials of the Hyper-V host. You can enter a friendly name for the credentials, followed by username and password. The appliance communicates to Hyper-V hosts using HTTPS protocol in port 5986, and if prerequisites are not met on the target servers, the communication falls back to HTTP in port 5985. To enforce HTTPS communication over 5986, enable the checkbox and ensure that certificate prerequisites are met on the target servers. Now we need to provide the Hyper-V host details. You can either add multiple Hyper-V host details or import multiple server details using a CSV template. For this demo, we add the FQDN of a single host and map it with its friendly credential name. The important point to note here is that the credentials are always stored inside the appliance. The credentials are encrypted using Data Protection APIs, or DPAPI, which is a secure 256 encryption. For deeper discovery of software inventory, agentless dependency analysis and discovery of SQL and .NET workloads, you need to provide the server credentials. Here we can add different types of credentials. We can either add domain credentials for a set of servers or add non-domain credentials like Windows, Linux, and SQL credentials. By providing this pool of credentials, appliance would intelligently map these credentials and perform deep discovery. If you are facing any issues with respect to appliance, you can execute run diagnostics to self-diagnose the issues without the need to open a support incident. After adding all the credentials, click on Start Discovery to initiate the discovery process, and it would take about 10 to 15 minutes for the data to reflect in Azure Portal. For next steps, to prepare for migrating the Hyper-V servers, download the Hyper-V replication provider. Watch the next video in the series to explore the discovered inventory, troubleshooting issues from Action Center, and to create a business case. Thank you for watching this video.